Oh, it's almost there. It's almost there. Oh! This has to be one of the most phenomenal astronomical events that you can see with your naked eye. I mean, I'm just looking at the sun right now. Oh, it got a little bit brighter around the edge. Well, we're here at the University of Nottingham in Nottingham, but we're getting ready to jump on a couple planes to go to China so that we can still be at the University of Nottingham. Well, there happens to be a total solar eclipse that's happening in just a little over a day, and it passes the path of totality, passes right over the University of Nottingham in Ningbo, China. At the moment, it looks like it's going to be cloudy, so I'm really, really hoping that the clouds are not with us.
It was small.
Thank you for waiting.
The forecast looks very grim. It seems that there's a front moving in tomorrow morning. It doesn't look good.
So here we are in China at the University of Nottingham Ningbo campus. We finally arrived. And so we're anticipating this big solar eclipse tomorrow while we're watching occasional lightning bolts, quite on cue right there. They just cover the entire half of the sky in the direction where the sun is actually supposed to rise tomorrow morning, where we're going to see this fantastic astronomical event, maybe. So I'm still keeping my hopes up, but I'm not positive that we're actually going to be able to see it. We've been traveling for 2 days, 2.5, I forget what day it is at the moment, but I know that tomorrow morning at 9:37 a.m. local time is when the big event happens. Well, it's 4:54 a.m. and we just came out to see what the sky looks like and to see what the potential is for the solar eclipse this morning, and it doesn't look very good. Not very promising indeed. Beautiful, but not good for a sun, for a solar event. We went out for the sunrise this morning and the weather did not look terribly fantastic, but after a little break and a cup of tea, we came back out again to see the clouds not quite so thick, and we can actually see the sun up there. So what I have right here is my very own solar filter that I made. This is a roll of black and white film. Now, it has to be actually black and white, not the color film that they just develop black and white, but real black and white film. So you expose it to the sun, and then you send it off to be developed, and then it has this nice layer of silver on there that acts as a filter for the ultraviolet and the infrared. That's the most harmful for your eyes. But we have a good chance of actually getting the solar eclipse. Okay, now I'm really excited. Yeah, in 10, maybe? 10 minutes. 10 minutes, it'll cover. So we've just reached the first contact point, and that's when the edge of the moon first touches the edge of the sun. So it's now just starting to pass in front of it. We have about an hour now until the total eclipse phase starts. So it's the sun, moon, and Earth in a straight line. The moon actually covers the sun. Well, it might seem slow, it takes the moon a while to cover the sun completely, but actually the shadow of the moon is barreling across the surface of the Earth at about 2,000 miles per hour. I'm fascinated by the idea of what ancient people thought when the sun just completely went away. There are different stories about how they reacted. The ancient Chinese, in fact, thought that dragons were attacking the sun and they were going to eat it and take it away. So what they decided to do was just make noise, beat drums, scream, make as much noise as they could to get rid of the moon and to keep the sun. And so luckily, every time that actually happened and they got the sun back.
欢迎来到宁波，希望你喜欢。 日全食.
Well, people have just decided to gather to watch. They've been using some of our solar eclipse glasses, and the kids are playing with feathers. They don't really know what's going on. They think the sun looks like the crescent moon, or they keep saying, I see the crescent moon! Because the moon's actually covering the sun.
Yeah.
So normally when the sun goes down, the animals start to go back to their burrows and go to sleep. And so right now they look like they are. The birds are kind of going away. They're small little floaty things that are leaving. And the ducks just started to go hide in the trees. But a couple kids went and yelled at them, so they didn't really know what to do. It was fantastic. Oh, it's almost there. It's almost there. Oh! Wow! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh, this has to be one of the coolest things I've ever seen. You can see the corona glowing around the sun, and the temperature just dropped completely, and everyone started cheering, and I completely didn't think we were going to be able to see it like that. Fireworks are going off! You could see a little bit of red at the very edge where we could see the last bit of light. It's amazingly dark. When I look through my binoculars, I can actually see some of the outer rings, some of the corona sort of flickering. And I don't think that's entirely due to the clouds. I actually think that has something to do with, with the light coming out. I mean, could you imagine, even thousands of years ago, seeing something like this and having any idea what was going on? You can hear people yelling in the distance and screaming and cheering. Oh my gosh. If we could actually see if there weren't any clouds. Oh, we can. There's Venus. Hey, there's Venus. So we can see the planet Venus right there, really bright. And if we could see the clouds around the sun, we'd be able to see Mercury. Yeah, this is amazing. This is amazing. The clouds are coming in a little bit more now, so you can't see it quite as well, but...
How does this rate on your astronomy experiences?
I mean, even with the clouds, this has to be one of the most phenomenal astronomical events that you can see with your naked eye. I mean, I'm just looking at the sun right now. Oh, it got a little bit brighter around the edge. Oh. And it just doesn't happen very often in each spot on the Earth. Oh my gosh! It just popped back out. That was a quick 4 minutes, I have to tell you. So the sun just popped back out on the other side of the moon, so it's brighter again instantly. So I'm wrapping a foil around our camera so we can actually look at it again. And now I have to use these. The next total solar eclipse will be in about 1 year from now. It's July 11th, 2010, and it will go over Easter Island and Chile and some of Argentina. So I have to figure out a good reason to go down there. So, University of Nottingham, campus Easter Island, maybe? We're just sitting here glowing with the enjoyment of what we just saw. It's amazing. That 4.5 minutes went so quickly.